blessed people, the Lord Jehovah has spoken with me this past night. The Lord Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah Sabaoth, the Lord of hosts, he has spoken with me this past night in a very, very tremendous way, in a very mighty, mighty way, in a very special way that I want to share with you tonight. And our blessed people, blessed saints of the Lord, this past night, the Lord visited with me in a very, very extraordinary and a very special and astounding way that I want to share to this very blessed dispensation, the blessed generation you are, the election of God that gets to see and hear some of these very shocking visitations that mark, they place hallmark on the time. They leave an indelible mark on the prophetic timeline of God, and they transmit the message that surely, yes, indeed, Christ Jesus the Messiah is coming. This past night, precious people, the Lord Almighty, he brought me to a place, and at that place, the Lion of God, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, he came all the way from heaven. And this time the Lord brought him very close. I could say about 5 or 6 meters away. And then he lay down there, the humongous, powerful, glorious Lion of heaven, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And he lay right in front of me there, facing me, but a little bit at an angle. It was on my right-hand side, but facing me. His head turned, he was facing me. And then the Lion of the tribe of Judah, he licked his feet a bit, and then again he faced me. A very, very shocking visitation, a very fierce and fearful visitation of God. The Lion of the tribe of Judah. This past night, the Lord God Almighty brought him and allowed him to visit with me in a tremendous historic visitation of all time in the morning hours of this past night, the past night. And he came all the way from heaven and he lay right there in front of me. He was lying there about 5 to 6 meters from me. Then facing a little bit towards my right, but his head turned facing me. Then he licked his legs, his front legs, a bit, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the glorious Lion of God, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. His name is Christ Jesus the King. You all know that the Lion symbolizes his kingship, his kingdom, his reign, but he is the King. I am reading right now from the book of Revelation, chapter 5, and he says here, from verse 1, he says, Revelation chapter 5, I'm reading from King James, and then I'll read also Amplified. It says, and I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the back side, sealed with 7 seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof? Verse 3 says, and no man in heaven, nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. Meaning to open the seals and look in. Again, verse 3. And no man in heaven, nor in earth, meaning the entire heaven, the entire earth, neither under the earth, even under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. In other words, to open the seals and look in and out. Because it's written on both sides. And he goes on to say, and I wept much, because no man was found worthy to open and read the book, neither to look thereon. And he goes on to say, I'm still reading King James, and one of the elders saith unto me, weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, hath prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. And he says, he goes on to say, and I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as it had been slain. I'm reading now, Amplified, blessed people. Amplified says, and I saw lying on the open hand of him who was seated on the throne a scroll, book, written within and on the back, closed and sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel announcing in a loud voice, who is worthy to open the scroll? Here he calls it the scroll, there he says the book. And who is entitled and deserves and is morally fit, entitled and deserves and is morally fit to break its seals? And no one in heaven, and no one on the earth, and no one under the earth, and in the realm of the dead, even the heads, was able to open the scroll or to take a single look at its content, the inside content and the outside content, because it's written both sides. And I wept audibly and bitterly, because no one was found fit to open the scroll and to inspect it. Continue with Amplified, it says, then one of the elders of the heavenly Sanhedrin said to me, stop weeping. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, the Source of David, he has won, and he has overcome and conquered. He can now open the scroll and break the seven seals. And there between the throne and the four living creatures, living beings, and among the elders of the heavenly Sanhedrin, I saw the Lamb standing as though he had been slain. So, blessed people, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the King, the Lion that the Lord God presented before me this past night, before his two tremendous prophets, before his most ancient and most glorious prophets that walk with God the Father in the open, broad daylight, caught live on video, that minister, the other one is wearing the eternal, everlasting, glorious body, and another one is wearing the physical body, the one that walked up in the chariot of fire, who never saw death. God the Father placed the Lion, the tremendous Lion, the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, the Source of David,
your heart. Toda Hashem. Toda Haber Sheli Hashem. Toda Haberim. Erev Tov. Toda Shalom. Toda Rabba. Toda. Shalom Toda.